नमस्कार विद्यार्थी मित्र आणि मैत्रिणींनो, सध्या कोरोना विषाणूमुळे आपण सर्वजण लॉकडाऊन मध्येच आहोत आणि सरकारी नियमांचं पालन करीत आहोत। सध्या आपल्या शाळा सुद्धा बंद आहेत आणि ते कधी सुरू होतील याबद्दल सुद्धा शाश्वती नाही। जरी शाळा बंद असल्या तरी सुद्धा विद्यार्थ्यांचं अध्ययन आणि अध्यापन चालूच राहावं या उद्देशाने सोलापूर जिल्ह्याचे मुख्य कार्यकारी अधिकारी माननीय श्री प्रकाश वायचळ सर, माध्यमिक विभागाच्या शिक्षणाधिकारी सौ सुधा साळुंखे मॅडम, सोलापूर जिल्हा माध्यमिक व उच्च माध्यमिक मुख्याध्यापक संघ, सोलापूर जिल्हा विज्ञान अध्यापक मंडळ, तसेच केवी संचलित मंगळूरी प्रशालेचे मुख्याध्यापक श्री जी बी पट्टर सर यांच्या प्रेरणेने आज आपण इथे ऑनलाइन क्लासेसच आयोजन केले आहे। मी श्री रमेश माटे सहशिक्षक केवी संचलित मंगळूरी प्रशाला अक्कलकोट आपल्या सर्वांचं ऑनलाइन क्लासेस मध्ये सहर्ष स्वागत करीत आहे। टुडे आई एम हियर फॉर यू टू डिस्कसिंग अबाउट वन इम्पॉर्टंट टॉपिक फ्रॉम साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी पार्ट फर्स्ट। डियर फ्रेंड्स, यू आर ऑलरेडी नोइंग अबाउट इलेमेंट्स एंड सम इम्पॉर्टेंट कंसेप्ट अबाउट इलेमेंट्स इन प्रीवियस ईयर। So friends, today also we are trying to understand more about elements. The name of the topic is Periodic Classification of Elements. This topic is in science first and the topic number is second. Therefore, we are concentrating about following points of this topic. Number one, elements and their classification, Dobereiner's tetrahedron, Newland's law of octaves, after then Mendel's periodic table, and finally today we are discussing in this topic modern periodic table. Friends, before that, here we just recall few points which were already studied in previous year. Let us start. Number one, what are the types of matter? Everyone know, very simple question. Solid, liquid, gaseous, as well as plasma, these are the four types of matter. One more is recently discovered, Bose-Einstein condensate. The question number second, that is, what are the types of elements? There are three types of elements: metal, non-metal, as well as metalloids. Metalloid means the elements which shows both metals as well as non-metals property, and there are total 8 elements belongs to metalloids out of 118 elements. The next question, the very important one, that is, what are the difference between molecules of element and compound? We have to differentiate. Very simple one. Actually, the element means these are the chemical substances made up of only one type of matter, and all 118 are the elements. For example, हाइड्रोजन ऑक्सीजन कैल्शियम आयरन ऑल दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ एलिमेंट्स एट द सेम टाइम व्हाट इज कंपाउंड दीज आर द केमिकल्स केमिकल सब्सटेंसेस कंबाइनिंग टू और मोर एलिमेंट्स इन फिक्स्ड प्रोपोर्शन देयर इज कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट्स फॉर एग्जाम्पल सोडियम क्लोराइड वाटर हाइड्रोजन क्लोराइड हाइड्रोजन सल्फाइड कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड ऑल दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कंपाउंड गॉट इट नाउ माय डियर फ्रेंड्स यू नो वेरी वेल देयर आर टोटल 118 एलिमेंट्स बट अराउंड 18th सेंचुरी there were only 30 elements were well known more number of elements was discovered in course of time as knowledge about elements and their properties went on increasing at the same time question arises about these elements how they are placed to understand this problem I want to say one example in front of you in case of library if all the books are kept in a haphazard manner haphazard means here and there not in a proper one then what will happen then it is very difficult for us to find a particular book in a short period of time so the all the books in the library are always kept in a proper manner okay similar problem of arrangement of elements were started so scientists were started trying out different methods of classification initially elements were classified into groups of metals as well as non-metals but in era of 1817 a famous scientist Dobereiner were classified these elements related to atomic mass what he did he made a group of elements group of three elements each having similar property similar chemical properties and called them a triad triad means simply group of three elements After then, what about Dobereiner's triad? In the Dobereiner's triad, he arranged the three elements in a triad in an increasing order of their atomic masses and showed that the atomic mass of middle element was approximately equal to mean of atomic mass of other remaining two elements okay let us see some examples here one child I'm telling lithium sodium and potassium let us we verify here whether the triad is correct or not One triad is there, lithium, potassium, and sodium. Atomic masses of lithium, potassium, and sodium are 6.9, 23, and 39.1 respectively. Therefore, mean of atomic masses of lithium and sodium is equal to 6.9 plus 39.1 upon 2. Therefore, what happened here? The addition 46.0 upon 2. Therefore, the atomic mean of atomic mass of lithium and potassium is equal to 23. Therefore, atomic mass of sodium is approximately equal to mean of atomic mass of lithium and sodium. Hence, we verified Dobereiner's triad. Okay? But one limitation related to that Dobereiner's triad. What is limitation? Before we discussing the limitation, let us discuss one more example. According to our examination of point of view, various types of question arises in our question paper. Different types of questions are there. Let us discuss one more example, which we are already asking in previous examination, I think in March 19 or March 18. Suppose there is one trial, it is named as unknown P, Q and R. P, Q and R. Atomic mass of P is equal to 35.5. Atomic mass of Q is equal to 79.9. Then what is the atomic mass of element R? All these are unknown elements. Let us assume atomic mass of elements R be X. According to Dobereiner's triad, atomic mass of R is equal to mean of atomic masses of elements P and R. Therefore, we put the value 79.9 is equal to 35.5 plus X upon 2. Therefore, 79.9 into 2 is equal to 35.5 plus X. Therefore, X is equal to 159.8 minus 35.5. Therefore, final answer, that is X is equal to, R is equal to 124.3. Therefore, the atomic mass of the unknown element R is equal to 124.3, and the actual mass of that element is 126.9. So we verified here, and also we find the value of unknown element with the help of Dobereiner's triad. After then, what is the limitation of Dobereiner's triad? In the Dobereiner's triad, only first 5 triads, means only 15 elements are obeyed the Dobereiner's triad. Only 15. After potassium, the remaining elements out of 33 elements were all well known at the time of Dobereiner do not follow the triad. So only 5 triads, 5 into 3 means 15 elements obey the Dobereiner's triad. This is the limitation of Dobereiner. Got it, my dear friends? After then, there was English scientist John Newlands, whose contribution in the classification of elements we are now discussing. In the era of 1866, Newlands' laws of octave described. What is the Newlands' law of octave? Let us see here. He arranged the elements in an increasing order of
the atomic masses, he found that every eighth element, properties of eighth element shows had the similar property to those of first. At the time of Newlyn, 56 elements were well known. He made one box, that is 7 into 8, 56 elements were accommodated. But in case of Newlyn also, some limitations are there. Which are the limitations? Let us discuss here. The first limitation is that the law applicable up to the element calcium, only after the calcium further elements do not obey the Newlyn's laws of octave. It is the first limitation. Number second limitation, in some places in the Newlyn's octave, two elements each in the same box. Means in one box he placed the two elements. For example, cobalt and nickel are placed in the same place. Ce and La are placed in the same place. So this is one limitation. So there are total two limitations to discuss. The third one, he placed some elements with different properties under same group. Means different property of these elements, but these are placed in a same group, that is the group of halogen. With the group of halogen, iron is also placed. That is one limitation. The next limitation, fourth limitation, Newlyn's octave did not have provision, means adjustment, to accommodate the newly discovered element. Suppose after completion of that Newlyn's octave, one new element were discovered. There were no provision for that element to accommodate in that table. So this is the fourth limitation of Newlyn's octave. Got it? So up to now we discussed from discovery of elements to arrangement of elements. Here some exercise means assignment for you. You have to prepare well and do study properly. Then definitely the science is very easy subject, and I want to suggest you, especially while you studying the science and technology, you just go through the textbook only. Textbook is the 100% perfect for studying. Okay, there is no other material is required for studying while your textbook. So friends, today we are stop here. We will meet in next session with same subject, same topic, but a different concept. That are the next scientist who was the successful than these two, Mendeleev, Dmitri Mendeleev. We will discuss Dmitri Mendeleev. After then, the very important concept, that is modern periodic table. But we will discuss in next session. Up to that, thank you very much. Stay at home, be safe. Thank you.